Good morning, my dear students. My name is Dr. K.C.H. Appara, working as an associate professor in Mechanical Department, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. Today, I want to explain about the LP model formulation, how to formulate the real-world problems into linear programming models. So, we'll see some steps or some phases to convert the problem, real-world problem, into LP models. The first of all, we'll see the formulating the problem in appropriate model. This is the formulating the problem in appropriate model. So, to do this, we have to follow some requirements, just like following the information is required. First of all, so who has to take the decision? We should know. Next, what are the objectives? We should know that. Next, what are the ranges of controlled variables? Ranges of controlled variables. We should know about that one also. So, next, what are the restrictions or constraints on the variables? We should know about that one. Okay. Wrong formulation cannot yield a right decision or solution. Okay. One should be careful while executing this phase. So, formulation of any model of the real world problems is very important. Okay. So, because wrong formulation of the problem into any model leads to just like wrong objectives. Okay. So, next we'll see some more steps. Next we'll see the phase number 2. So, this is the next to constructing a just like mathematical model. Constructing a mathematical model. So, for that, just like this one is the, you know, the second phase. So, in which just like 3 basic factors are very important. Important factors. One is the decision on variables or decision variables and parameters. Okay. So, these are very important. Next, constraints or restrictions. These are also very important. Next one is the objective function. That may be maximization objective function or minimization objective function. So, that one is the second phase. Now, we will see the phase number 3, third phase. Next, derivation solutions. Deriving the solutions from the model. So, this phase is devoted to the computation of decision variables, calculation of the decision variables. So, that optimize the objective function. So, that is the just like how to find out the decision variables, values of the decision variables. Yes, you have to find out. So, next one, we'll see the phase number 4. Okay. Testing the model. So, and its solution. So, after finalizing the objective function, next to how to just test the model. So, after completing the model, so it is once again tested as a whole for the errors, if any. So, you have to check for the if there is any errors. So, okay. A model may be said to be valid. So, if it can provide a reliable predictions, okay, of the system performance. So, for that clarification, we have to test the model. So, next one is the controlling the solution. Okay. Controlling the solution. So, okay, this phase establishes the controls over the solution with any degree of satisfaction. So this model requires immediate modification as soon as the control variables change significantly. So otherwise the model goes out the control. How to check that one also? So next last one is the just like implementing the solution. After all the just testing and validation, then you go for the implementation or implementing the solution. So that is the final step. So that tested results of the model are implemented to work. So this phase primarily executed with the cooperation of the operation research experts and those who are responsible for managing and operating the systems. So these are the just like 6 phases to convert the real world problems into formulation into just like models, just like linear programming models, and just testing of those variables or objectives, and just validate the objectives, then implementing the solutions. So now we'll see one example how to convert the real world problem into just like LP models, linear programming model. So there is one example, we'll see this one. So a film manufactures so 2 types of products. One is the product A and the second product B. So sells them at a profit. So profit of the first product A, so that is the rupees 2 per piece. So next to 3 rupees on type B, so per each piece. So each product is processed on 2 machines. There are 2 machines, they have to be machined, 2 types of machining on 2 machines. So one is the G type machine, another one is the H type machine. Type A requires 1 minute of processing time on G and 2 minutes on H. So that is the constraints, time based constraints. So next to type B, so it requires 1 minute on G and 1 minute on H. Okay. So the machine G is available for not more than the 6 hours 40 minutes. So this is the limit of the time. 6 hours means 6 into 60. So 360 plus 40. So 400 minutes available time. So on machine G. So similarly, while machining H is available for the 10 hours. So it means 10 into 60, 600 minutes are available on a particular day. So to perform the different operations on machine G. Okay. So we have to formulate the problem as a linear programming problem. So convert this problem into linear modeling or linear equations. So we'll see first of all one by one. So first of all, we'll see just like first step one. So decision variables. So let X1 or X or Y or X1. X1 is the number of products of a type A. So total number of products will be manufactured in that company on particular day on any on per day. So that is the. So next one is the just like X2 is the number of products of type B. So per day. So that is the total number of products of type B per day. Okay. So we have to calculate these values at optimized level. So for that, just like we have to consider all the constraints. What are the given the numerical? So we'll see. First of all, this is the table for the clear understanding. So we know that there are 2 machines, machine G and machine H. Okay. So 2 types of products are there, the type A product A and the type B product. So X1 is the number of products of type A, and X2 is the number of products of type B. So on particular day. So this is the available time. You know that. We will see first of all, profit is given. And sells them at a profit of 2 rupees on type A. So this is the rupees 2 on type A. So and rupees 3 on type B. Okay. So by using these profits, we can write the objective function. By using these constraints values, then you can write the constraints, linear equation constraints. We'll see one by one how to write these things. Okay. Means how to convert this general problem into numerical formulas. So once you prepare the numerical formulas, just like the mathematical formulas, then you can find out the values. Okay. So with that, this is the same table I have taken here for the explanation. So first of all, we'll see the total profit for X1 units of type A. So and X2 units of type B. So you know that is the X1 is the number of products of type A can be produced, can be manufactured on a day. So it means that cost of one piece is 2 rupees. Then total cost, total profit, not cost, total profit is the 2x1. Similarly, for type B, total profit is the 3x2. Then profit function or objective function, it is simply represented by Z. So Z is equal to 2x1 plus 3x2. This is the objective function. So in numerical, just like in words, it was given in problem. So that was converted into just like equation form. That is called objective function. Okay. So next we will see the constraints. So this is the objective function. So now we'll see the constraints. Okay. So first of all, considering the processing time. So time-based constraints. So considering the processing time on machine G. Okay. So based upon the machine G and based upon the machine H, two types of constraints we can prepare here. So by using this data. So that is the just like based upon the G. Okay. So 1 minute takes to prepare the product A, or just like, and 1 minute takes to prepare the B type product. Okay. So it is the mean, it means so if the X1 is the number of products of type A, then 1x1, it means the 1x1 is the total time to prepare the operation on machine G. And B takes the 1x2, the total time to process the operation on machine G. So 1x1 plus 1x2 is less than or equal to 400. So 400 is the just like maximum available time on particular just like machine G. Okay. So the total time of two types of products, 1x1 plus 1x2 is equal to 4400 or less than 400. So we cannot just perform more minutes than the 400 minutes, just like. So this is the first constraint. So now we'll see the second constraint. This is the first constraint. So now we'll see the second constraint. So considering the processing time on mission H. So we'll see the based upon the H. Okay. So here 2 minutes takes to prepare the operation for product A, and 1 minute takes to prepare to perform the operation for the product B and particular mission G. So that is the just like so 2x1 plus 1x2. This is the total time to perform operations on mission H. So this is the always less than or equal to 600. So available time is the 600 minutes. Okay. So less than or equal to 600. So that is the second constraint. Just like you can given here also. This is the constraint two, second constraint. So this is the objective function. This one is the first constraint. This one is the second constraint. Next, we will see that we know that there is no negativity. So since it is not possible to produce the negative quantities, so quantities either may be zero or more than zero, one or two or any quantities. So we can write like this: x1 always greater than or equal to zero, or x2 always greater than or equal to zero. So finally, x1 comma and x2 always greater than or equal to zero. So because there is no negative quantities. So this is the, in this way, just like we can convert the just a general problem into numerical model, just like LP models. Here, this is the non-negativity restrictions or constraints. So this is the final just like LP problem. So finally, this the problem what was expressed in the general words are converted into numerical values or equations. So that is the LP model problem. Okay. So just like so to solve this one, there are so many types of techniques: simplex method and graphical method and BGM method. So by using those techniques, we can solve this one and we can find out the x1 and x2 values at optimized level. So at just like optimized levels, that is the object of this one. So this is the one type of numerical. Okay. So we'll thank you for this one. So next class we'll discuss some more numericals on LP models, how to formulate the LP models of different real world process.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.